it was amazing, and we were able to look around and see that people, the youth, wanted change.
Henry Sibley High School students spent the weekend in Washington for the March for Our Lives, and their first stop when they returned today was the state capitol to pressure lawmakers to allow hearings on gun bills.
You shouldn't let how far the finish line is prevent you from taking the first steps.
The Sibley students got to meet privately with Senator Warren Limmer, the Republican who heads the Judiciary and Public Safety Committee, who hasn't scheduled hearings on the gun bills.
He kept circling back to, well, we need to have a conversation not centered around emotion. This needs to be a more thoughtful, clear conversation.
So, you know, I appreciate him listening to us, but it seemed to me like he had lost hope and that he didn't want to take the blame for it. He didn't want lawmakers to be responsible for laws.
Among those who took the trip to D.C. with the Sibley students was Senator Matt Klein of Mendota Heights.
But if we can't discuss this acute and excruciating tragedy in the committee rooms of the state legislature, then why do they bother to send us here?
The pressure they're putting on the system isn't Democrats and Republicans. They're looking at all of us together.
Senator Latz wants to gather votes and make this an election issue.
Opponents of the gun bill say it's a waste of time to hold hearings if the votes aren't there.
There isn't the votes to push these out of committee, and I don't believe they have the votes to even push them off the floor.